Hello and welcome to the course. In today's lecture, we will learn about variables in Dux. The benefits of using variables are, the first is performance. Like each value that is stored in the variable is calculated just once. The second is the reusability. We can reuse the values multiple times. And the third is readability and maintenance. It is easy to read your code and it is easy to maintain the code. So let's do it in the Power BI desktop. For this, we will create, let me show you the table. As you are familiar with, we have midterm, final term, marks and some other stuff. And let's create one measure. We just the modeling tab, we can give a new measure. We just need to calculate the percentage marks for every student. We can rename it total obtained marks is equal to sum x. The first parameter is marks. The expression is midterm marks plus final term marks. So this is the first measure, and the other is we need one more, total marks is equal to sum, and here we need to just give one column, total marks. The name total marks is already used for a column on a table marks. Choose a different name. Okay. What we can do is we can add like marks total. And then the third is we need to create one more measure, student marks percentage, and total obtained marks, the first measure that we have created, and divided by marks total. Hit enter. And then we just need to click, and we just need to set the format, and see, this is the student marks. And if I need to add some kind of rating, I need to add one more measure, like rating is equal to if student marks is greater than then we can say okay, then its rating is A, otherwise its rating is B. And see, we have to create first measure and then second measure, and then we have to create a rating, and there are lot of stuff that we have created to achieve our rating. So how we can get the same result by using variables? So let's do it with variables. I have to create one measure like rating with variables. First you need to write var, the keyword, and then the name of a variable, obtained marks. Then you have to write like sum x, the same formula that we have written previously. The table is marks, then expression midterm marks plus final term marks. Then the second variable, like total marks, sum, and here we have to write total marks. The third variable, like marks percentage, and here you can use the previously created variables like obtained marks divided by total marks, and see the icon. This is XY. This icon represents variable, and then you have to use one keyword return, and now we can use these variables. Like if I say if marks percentage is greater than 0.65, then rating is A, otherwise rating is B. That's it. And then we can add this newly created measure with variables on the report. Rating with variable, here it is. Here you can see we got the same result, like rating A, B, A, B, B, A. Fine. So this is how we can use variable to simplify our code. It's very simple to do all the stuff in one formula. Let's meet in the next lecture.